it back into darkness. And let's walk through our little tunnel here. So we're going to do the same thing on this one. Only I think it needs to be a different size. Should be checking based on distance over here. So that is as far as I want to go. Meaning that one goes there. That one goes there. That one there. That one there. And that one there. And that's our outside limit. I'm thinking we haven't had a fully collapsed wall yet. And this seems to indicate that something bad happened here. So let's do that. Let's have a collapsed wall on this side. First, I need to figure out what size I just made, because this is, I think, one of the bigger towers. This is bigger than our other small tower. So, if it goes out, the outer edge, no, this is a 13. Yeah, this is a 13. So, what we can do, first we're going to start with the mossy stone bricks. One, two, three, four. And let's throw down a marker there because we want to make sure. Ooh, not with that red though. That might be confusing. Let's use cyan. Okay, so there's the 5 for each side. We'll do the same thing over here, actually. 1, 2, 3. And that'll actually be part of it. And then over here. And the 13 uses that W. So I'll be using that again in a second here, but let me do this first. All right. So it's, ooh, that was really close. Literally right on the edge, which I like. I'm glad that happened. And then put the dubs there. And that would be our shape there. So, perfect. And I really like the way that looks with the connector there. So overall, I'm pleased with that. So since our floor seems to be fairly level, pretty much all over, and it is also almost entirely made. Yes, made of gravel. That's excellent. We don't have to do anything to it. We'll just build up with our cobblestone. I do think, though, that I should probably put our mossy in first, so I don't forget. Nice. Now we'll do a level of cobble. As I said, this is going to be our collapse tower. This is going to be our damaged one. So I'm thinking maybe a full window on this side. And then just a big hole in the wall on the other. So. Oh, well, technically, you know, our whole thing should be up higher. Oops. Let's go ahead and do that. Make more sense if we do. Otherwise our windows will be off and it won't make any sense. But actually if we make it so that the collapse is even more obvious, that could be really great. This was the original floor. But something, you know, the big catastrophe happened on that side. And so the floor fell out along with it. So we'll go with that. Now, obviously, there's going to be a piece of wall over here that just fell out. It had a bad day. Question is, if I do that, nah, that looks pretty nasty. That looks like a nice piece that fell. Perfect. That's exactly what I wanted that piece to do. Too parallel. Be a little far away from our origin point there. All right. One thing that makes things look collapsed is whenever they sort of rip and tear as they come down. So if you have every now and then kind of a spire that sticks up, you know, it really does look ruinous. This stuff stays in ways that you wouldn't expect it to. Oh, I'm building the windows backwards. Now, I could actually put a window there, but I don't think I'm going to. Sometimes whenever you put it on the end like that, it looks funny when it sticks out, so. Go there on this one. This is the one that I was thinking of doing as full. Oh. Full set, or nearly full set. And yeah, I think I will. So let's do. Good to me. Neat thing about this little W shape is that you can have these damaged trench areas and it looks like holes in the castle without punching light all the way through it. I really like that. That's also a nice thing about having it just too thick at any time. Meaning two blocks thick. So, that's something to keep in mind. Really important is to make sure all these don't go the same angle. One of the ways that you can destroy the visuals on any of this stuff is to just have the same thing going the same direction over and over and over again. This one is a perfect case of a spire that needs to be sticking up a lot higher. My question is that too high? Yeah, I think we're actually at too high at that point for what that originally was. But that's okay. Just bringing it up just a little bit fixes the problem. Also, I know that this part was not too high, because this is off the tower. And this was a tall tower. I'm sure of it. Excellent. Oh, we're losing our light again. This wall got ripped out, so clearly there's going to be some damage. And always keep in mind what it was that would have been here. For example, right here, this would have been a window. So There would have been a window here and here and here. And if I wanted to, do that ripping effect, I could remind everybody by simply doing that. So it turns out the foundation was pretty good after all, because apparently part of it's going to stay. But you know what? I really like the way that looks. So we're going to keep it. Raise that up just a little bit by doing that. And then I don't actually need any of the bars or anything for that to work. But because of the way it's only doing it as a half, I may keep that. If I can. If I do this instead, suddenly it's a piece from there. And that works for me. All right, these are going to be fairly normal, but I won't make them too high. I don't want to draw attention away from the other coolness that we have. We could bring a passage out this way, but I don't know. For some reason, I'm feeling like maybe not doing that. Yeah. I'll do this. I haven't done that exact formation yet. It's the window tops. That works. Nice. I think we're calling that one done. Alrighty, so I'm going to start in on what will basically be Oh, it's kind of a cathedral, but it's going to be the Great Hall. And what I've done here is a circle that is 17, but I'm only going to do half circle because I want the rest to be kind of in that cathedrally cross shape that's so classic. But I like the idea that it sticks out over the edge here. We got all kinds of fun formations like this is hanging out over here. So I've gone ahead and blocked it off.